In 2017, three women went blind after paying a so-called stem cell clinic in Florida thousands of dollars to treat their macular degeneration.
Which is weird, because a year ago, Julian was here talking about the new and exciting advances in stem cells. So why are these stem cell therapies dangerous? And why aren't real, safe, effective therapies on the market yet?
I know, right? I mean, things like this keep happening across the US, which made the FDA basically say,
hold up, these unproven and unsafe products purport to address a serious disease, but instead could, quote, put patients at significant risk.
We've talked about stem cells before on this channel, going over what they are and how they work, and some of the groundbreaking stem cell treatments that are showing promise.
But the early flagship trial that hoped to improve macular degeneration, a disease leading to eventual blindness, was halted after just one patient received treatment due to concerns of any threat to the long-term health of those participating in the trials.
That's how cautious real clinical trials are. They really try to minimize any risk before they bring treatments to patients.
That early trial was suspended back in 2014, and there's still only one stem cell therapy that's officially approved by the FDA, bone marrow transplants to treat those with blood cancer. Because bone marrow is where our stem cells live when we're adults.
There are a ton more FDA-vetted clinical trials in the pipeline, but those are not fully-fledged treatments yet. They're just tests to see how it works, if it's effective, and what the side effects are, so that researchers can go on to make a product or procedure that actually works.
The flood of stem cell clinics that have been popping up all over the world, promising to cure everything from blindness to joint damage to neurodegenerative disease, all share one telltale sign: they charge patients for treatment.
Vulnerable people seeking cures to health ailments are paying companies large sums of money to receive a treatment that's not even at clinical trial stage. In the FDA's words, these are treatments with a worrisome lack of evidence that they work at all, and they may actively be harmful.
See, most legitimate clinical trials of treatments like this will cover the costs of treatment for the patient through a pharmaceutical company or foundation, precisely because it might not work. It's not yet a fully developed treatment. So paying for a clinical trial, that can be warning flag numero uno.
Profit-oriented companies scamming sick people out of their money are taking advantage of consumer confusion around this topic.
Stem cell science is in the news a lot because scientists are making incremental progress, but this is happening in the lab, demonstrating how stem cells may be used in the future to treat patients.
It's a highly reported on topic because it's an exciting one that could change the future of medicine, but science takes a long time.
Yeah. So let's get it straight. Embryonic stem cells are heavily regulated and hard to access, but nothing is stopping faux treatment facilities from taking cells from a patient's body, turning those into stem cells. These are called induced pluripotent stem cells, or iPSCs.
The Florida clinic that blinded three women extracted the patient's belly fat, went through that process to turn it into stem cells, and then injected it into their eyes. The problem is that iPSCs from fully formed adult tissue can only turn into that tissue, so fat stem cells can only turn into fat, and they injected it into their eyes. iPSCs still do hold huge promise for repairing patients' damaged tissue, and researchers are always looking for ways to extract and multiply the stem cells we have as adults that can turn into anything, because that would allow us to repair any damage anywhere on the body. It's just that there's no legitimate treatment out there yet.
Scientific research like this is exciting, and there's a ton of it out there, and science nerds like us are talking about it a lot because it's cool. But as we've seen, we do need to be careful about how we talk about it.
The next time you see an ad online for a stem cell clinic promising a miracle cure, maybe dig a little deeper. There are some people who will take advantage of the hype around this basic research for their own gain, making people believe that fully fledged treatments are out there, even though they're really not.
Everyone, this is Marin. Marin, meet everyone. Marin is new to the channel. She's a science communicator. She's super good at environmental science, animal behavior, biology. You'll be seeing her more on the channel, so give her a warm welcome.
Hi.
Oh.
And check out this video about some recent exciting stem cell research developments. But take a minute to think about how experiments like this are different from an actual treatment. We think it's just as important to talk about the realities of science as it is to geek out over the flashy stuff, so subscribe if you think so too. I'm Marin.
I'm Trace. Thanks for watching Seeker.